really not surprising, but tell us what the reason is.
Yeah, so they've got an 82% drop in their net profit. It's massive. So they had like their net profit was $3.1 million for the year ending June, and that compared with $17.5 million the year before. Revenue was also down, and look, they're not even paying a dividend to their shareholders. The farming community is doing it tough, and so that reflected in what we've seen in TGG Wrightson. Commodity prices have been weak, and so on. So yeah, it's all in line with what we've been seeing. Where it ends, we don't know, but I tell you what, the market's not taking any chances. It wrote down their share price today 9.5%, which is fairly hefty. And what about the risk going on the market? Not bad. The local top 50 index, it ended up nearly a third of a percent. It was a 38-point gain to 12,319. And the New Zealand dollar is at 60.3 US cents, 91.5 Australian, 47.2 British pence. There's a lot of economic data that we're expecting this week. There's going to be some key inflation data later this week from the in the U.S. That's going to be important. Of course, tomorrow we've got closer to home, Reserve Bank of New Zealand is going to come out with the monetary policy statement with all eyes on what's going to happen with the official pass rate. Nobody knows. It's quite divided. Some people say it will just stay the same. Others are expecting the Reserve Bank to cut. We'll have to wait till tomorrow to find out, won't we? Thank you, Nanya. Nanya Peltier there with Business News. Let's get some of your feedback now before the headlines. On our earlier interview with Tama Kotaka, the Minister for Foreign Economic Relations, and this is the proposal to shake up Te Ariwhiti, the office for Māori Crown Relations. This office is far out. Tama Kotaka using a lot of words to say nothing. Someone else though giving him a high five, saying too many layers of bureaucracy, too many people with their fingers in the Māori affairs pot for too long. Well done, Tama Kotaka. Another though, what a ruffler. When they keep using your name, you know they're on the back foot. This one too, the crock. Why don't they ever answer the questions they are being asked? And another listener's got in touch with me. Oh my gosh, Tama Kotaka couldn't even answer a simple question. That trolleying out the party line was more important. What measures does he hold himself accountable to? I bet none, that listener says. On the subject of dog walkers and how many they should be allowed to walk at any one time, this person says, I trained dogs when I was young. I grew up around working dogs with a German Shepherd who was once left at a rural bus stop with dogs today. He did not leave that bus stop until I returned many hours later. Now, at 9 years old, having never broken a command while walking down a country road, he attacked a sheep and was totally out of my control. No one should be walking past dogs, he said. And this listener raises an interesting point before we move on, which is, how does a dog walker in control of 20 dogs pick up their poo? That is a good logistical question, and sadly, I do not know the answer. It is 20 to 6, and to which checkpoint on RNZ National. Keep your feedback coming, 2101 on text, or you can tweet us at checkpoint RNZ. That's one we'll go to the headlines with Anna, or Anna Arlotina.
Thanks, Lisa. The Minister for Māori Crown Relations and Māori Development insists many area Māori leaders want absolute clarity on the responsibilities of government agencies. The government is paying back responsibilities of Te Ariwhiti, the Office of Māori Crown Relations, and shifting them to the Ministry for Māori Development, Stephanie Kōkiri. Tama Kotaka tells the point that Te Ariwhiti will continue as a departmental agency in its core role of progressing treaty and fishing settlements, while Te Puni Kōkiri will fulfil its statutory duties on policy advice. The Green Party has sounded a note of caution about the government's plan to shake up genetic engineering laws, saying the public must first be consulted on any topic of genetic engineering. The Green Party spokesperson Steve Abel says he sees the government as overstating the benefits, asked whether he could be convinced otherwise. He says the Greens are keen to be part of the conversation. An environmental group is hailing an environment court ruling as a win. It will send a clear message to forestry companies that there are now real repercussions for land mismanagement. Chinese-owned China Forestry Group has been told to make sure no significant woody debris or settlement leaves a harvest site. The court action was tackled by the Brisbane District Council and Mona Tawa Te Ariwhiti after year Voice 1.